everybody, what's up and welcome back to another video. For the scent of the day, I'm still working on this Mainstays candle and it's called Apple Cider Donut. And I live for a Yankee candle, but these come pretty close. I love these a lot and you cannot beat them for $3. If you're new to this channel, then hello and welcome. And I urge you to hit the subscribe button and possibly the notification bell. I do post a lot of things and I would hate for you to miss anything interesting. I also do post every single day on Instagram as well as Reddit. So if you like content that's updated daily, be sure to go follow me over on there. Well guys, for today's video is something kind of fun. I watch a lot of Emily Noel's videos and recently she just posted a video about this big mega palette that had a bunch of different steps in it and you can pretty much get away with doing your entire face and eye look with just that one palette. And in her video, she called it a challenge. So I am taking her up on that challenge and I got a mega face palette for myself and I'm gonna see how far I can get with it personally. These big all-in-one face palettes look like they're really fun, but sometimes they sacrifice that for quality. So today I'm gonna try to see if the quality matches up with the general appeal of this. So before we get started with the application, why don't we just kind of familiarize ourselves with this palette and see what it's all about. So here's the entire palette. It comes in this really nice box and it's pretty big when you're just looking at it. And I actually got this one from Amazon. I know the one that Emily got in her video was from Ulta, but I thought it would be fun to use a different palette than she did so it wouldn't be like the same kind of video. So when I open up the box, here's what it looks like. And you can see all the little eyeshadows peeking out. And then when you look at it this way, you can see that there's multi-layers to this thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up the first layer. So here's what it looks like when I open up the first layer. You can see all the eyeshadows in here. And I'm really wondering if they're good shadows or not because there's a lot of pretty colors in here. And then something really neat about this palette is that these just fold out like this. And then there's even more eyeshadows in here. So now you have all these eyeshadows to play with. And then if you pull these out even more, you have more things. So it looks like in the back here, we have a whole bunch of correctors and concealers. And then right here, we have some blushes. And then right here are some face highlighters. And then in this little compartment right here is a small little lip gloss. And then in this compartment over here is a teeny little mascara. And then here's all these little tools you can use if you don't have anything on you. You can really use those. So I'm gonna shut this top part. And then we're gonna open the second layer. So the second layer just pulled out from the bottom like this. And then if you look at it head on, these are all your lip colors. So they give you a very generous amount of lip colors to play with. And then just like the top, you do slide these out like the same way. And then you're introduced to four different bronzers. And then in the middle, you have three different colors of brow powders. So yeah, I'm really excited to dig into this thing and see how good it is. Okay, so for this challenge, I'm gonna try to get as much use out of this for a full face as I can. So the first thing I'm gonna dig into are these three little correctors over here. And I'm gonna use all those and apply them to my face. Okay, I'm starting with the lavender shade. And what I'm gonna do with the lavender one is I'm just going to apply this under my eyes. That's a really nice corrector. So the next shade I'm going into is the green. And I'm gonna cover up any acne scars, anything that's red on my face, I'm just gonna dot this little green corrector on. And finally, I'm gonna dip into the red color corrector and put this on my upper lip mustache area where my melasma is. All right, so after blending this, I have some thoughts about this, guys. To be honest with you, I think these are some really, really, really great color correctors. I'm a total fan of color correcting and I do it all the time. And I have certain ones that I keep falling back on that I really rely on. And these are pretty much on par with how my favorite ones are. I would equate these to how the Becca one performs and that is my absolute favorite color corrector. If nothing else works in this palette for the rest of the way, I will definitely keep this around just to use those. So the next step is to put on a base, and since that doesn't come in a palette, I'm just gonna go quickly put one on. For today, I'm just gonna use this CoverGirl Clean Matte BB Cream. For a BB cream, this has some pretty outstanding coverage, and I do really enjoy this. And I recently just got this on Amazon for $2, so can't beat that. Okay, so now the next step is concealers, and those are located in the back right here. And since they're kind of creamy concealers, I'm gonna take one of these sponge tip applicators and just go into it and kind of apply it under my eye with this little thing and then blend it out with a brush. The concealer did a great job of both highlighting and concealing my dark circles, so pretty happy with that. There is absolutely nothing wrong with it. The only thing that I can think of is that some people might not like the thought of having to apply it in two steps, but as far as application, it's a really beautiful concealer. So now again, this palette doesn't have a setting powder, so I'm just gonna go in with this It Cosmetics setting powder really quick. Okay, so the next step is bronzer, and that's these two powders and these two powders over here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put them on a big brush and mix all four of them together. I like to use a really big bronzing brush. I'm actually happy that these powders are large enough that you can fit a large brush in there very easily. So here's how my face looks with the bronzer on, and I think it did an excellent job, and it blended out super easily, so no qualms about that at all. So now the next thing we're going into are these three little blushes over here, and again, I'm just gonna dip my brush into all of them and mix them together. As for the blushes, they give you two matte blushes and one shimmer blush. So here's the blush, and what are we working with here, guys? This palette works so good. I'm super impressed with it so far. I honestly was thinking this whole video was gonna be a flop. Seriously, I'm pretty amazed. So now the next thing is highlighter, and we're gonna just mix all these three together right here. So I'm sure you can build the highlighter up, but I always like to wear it in a diffuse manner, but you can kind of see it on my cheek when it hits the light right there. It's just very, very subtle and beautiful. So now the next thing that I wanted to do is get into these brow products right here. So I'm going to use powder in my brows today, which I usually don't, but hey, we're gonna try it today. I'm just gonna quickly brush my brows out, kind of shape them a little bit. So for this powder, I'm gonna go in with this Zoeva 317 brush, and this is the best brush for doing your brows because it's the thinnest one I've ever found, and it allows you to be very precise with it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in with this darker powder, and I'm gonna put this on the back half of my brow. And then I'm gonna go into the lightest shade, and then I'm going to put that in the front of my brow. And then when I get to the center part, I'm just kind of slightly taking the lighter powder and dragging it over to the darker powder so they blend together. So here's how the brow came out, and I wouldn't say it looks too bad. Like I said, I normally don't use powder, so it's kind of different to me, but I think it turned out all right. Now, every time you do your brows, you're gonna want to set them with a gel just so the powder stays in and lasts all day for you. So now is the moment of truth. It's eyeshadow time. So I was thinking I'm gonna do something a little bit more neutral to kind of match my green shirt. So I'm just gonna grab a very fluffy brush and then find a shade that would be a good transition shade for me. Just going to put this in the crease. So what I'm noticing by using this already is that these pans are so tiny that my brush, when I'm trying to put it in, it's hitting multiple pans at once, and that can get really aggravating. But I just kind of have to pinch it a little bit and go in there with it, and I can make it work. So now I'm gonna take my Secret outer corner brush and go into a really deep dark matte shade that I find in here so I can really deepen up my outer corner. So now I'm just gonna give this a quick blend because I'm really excited to dig into these shimmer shades. So now I'm so excited, I'm gonna go into a green shimmer shade. So this is not picking up very well on a brush, so I'm gonna try my finger. Yeah, it's not so good with my finger either. I mean, it's not terrible. Like, you can see the color and you can see that it's a shimmer, but it's just not giving me the high reflectivity that I usually like. Here, you can look at it up close. It's not really anything special. All right, now I'm going into like a pearlized shade. I just don't get a lot of payoff with my brush. They just don't want to pick up on a brush. The matte shades picked up super well on a brush, but the shimmers just don't want to. Okay, so there's the eye look. Now we got three more things left. We got the mascara, we got the lip colors, and the lip gloss. And I'm not skipping any steps. So let's give this mascara a shot. One thing that I'm happy about is I did get zero fallout from that eyeshadow. So here's the mascara. It just says Charm Code Mascara on it. And it's got a full-size brush on there, just like a natural bristle wand. Okay, so I'm really picky with mascaras, and now you can look at this eye has it on, and this eye does not. And it kind of clumped it up, and it's like a sticky mascara, and I'm just not a fan of this one. I probably won't ever wear it again, but I'm gonna finish it on the other eye just so they can be even. All right, so I'm just gonna pick one of these dark lips that I find in here, something that might match. It's kind of hard to tell how the shade's gonna look. Okay, so that's the second darkest lip color in this palette. And I love, love, love playing with lip palette. So that was really fun to me. And I'm definitely gonna dig into this more to play with that. But now it's time to put on the lip gloss. So that's actually a really nice lip gloss. So when it comes to this, I have to say there were definitely some hits, definitely some misses. But overall, I had an absolute blast playing with this. And when I review products, that is definitely an assessment I like to make. And another aspect that I like to talk about is, will I ever use this again? And the answer to that is yes. I'm definitely gonna dig back into this for a few of the products in here. My experience with this one was really, really good. The shimmer eyeshadows didn't blow me away and the mascara really sucked. But other than that, everything else was great and the color correctors in here are life-changing. And I really like the look that I got out of this palette. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. So guys, that's all for my video today. I hope you really enjoyed it and found it helpful. And if you did, please give a big thumbs up. And if you didn't, hit the thumbs down button. And until next time.